Hi Foxes, and welcome back to my channel, or if you are new here, welcome. My name is Brittany and I am known as ShopFoxBURROW across websites like Instagram and Poshmark and Etsy and here on YouTube. And I like to create a lot of content around vintage style and vintage fashion, and in particular like selling it, but I also really enjoy creating styling content and just bringing that like vintage whimsy into my modern closet. So recently I have been doing Stitch Fix, and I've been getting Stitch Fix for I think like almost 3 years now, and I've just been finding their selection recently has been really lacking, and I have not been enjoying getting my boxes very much. And I know that they're changing some stuff up, like you can preview your box kind of like Trunk Club now, but I thought that I would try this new styling service called Short Story. And it is a styling service for petite women. So I am 5'4". That's like the very top edge of petite. But sometimes I do find that modern like lengths and inseams are kind of long on me. So that's one of the reasons I kind of love vintage clothing, because everything is for short people like me. But yeah, I thought that I would open this up with you guys and see what is inside. I am not completely sure if I'm going to do a try-on video or if I'm just going to like unbox this with you. It kind of depends on how exciting the stuff inside is. If it's kind of boring, I think I probably won't do a try-on video, but if I'm excited about it, then I will do a try-on video. So let's see what they sent me. Just like Stitch Fix, I was able to go in and put in like a style profile and send them my link and say what type of stuff I was interested in. But yeah, I don't know what kind of options they're gonna have to pick from. So here is all of the information. It says I have 5 days to decide what to keep, which it's been longer than 5 days. So hopefully they didn't bill me for all this stuff. That would be really bad. But anyway, yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and see what's in this box. Oh, I see something that I really like. So here is the box. It's super boring on top. They sent like a black sweater or something, but peep that. Oh, it's like little daisies and it's kind of like a sheer print. Oh, so cute. I'm excited about that. So let's see what we got here. Okay, they sent a turtleneck type sweater. This is by the brand Yimak, which is actually, they used to sell this brand at ModCloth, but it was called Mac B, and they do a ton of cardigans, and so I actually have a bunch of stuff by this brand, and I do like it. It holds up pretty well. So yeah, just kind of like a cute little black sweater. I don't need any black sweaters right now, so I don't think I'll be keeping that. Let's see. Oh, I really hope this fits. This is so cute. Oh, it's like a little crop top. It's by Lilis, which is a brand that Stitch Fix actually used to sell. You can see that there, and it's like sheer with this little daisy pattern. But tucked into skirts. Oh, that would be so cute. If I could find... Oh, I have a yellow skirt. Oh, I like that. Oh, another floral. Oh, look! They sent a skirt to style it with. And this has a really cute, like, belt with a big buckle here. That's really cute. This is by... I don't know. It has a Short Story tag on it. Maybe it's by them. Oh, San Suchi. I thought that was an Urban Outfitters brand. I'm not sure. Well, that's really cute. It's like a midi length skirt. It is polyester and it does not seem to have pockets. So that's a downside, but definitely my style and definitely cute. So I'm gonna try this on with the daisy top because I think they're probably intended to go together. You guys, this is, I cannot believe this. I'm so impressed right now. This is a like novelty print with stars. It's by the brand LA Soul. I do have a little fox dress by this brand. They sell it at like the mall here, but their dresses have pockets. And that's really cute. Oh, it's a jumpsuit. Oh my gosh. Oh wow, I'm impressed. I don't think this is going to fit my waist. I think I'll probably need an extra large, but I'm gonna try. I'll probably have to wear shapewear, but I'm gonna try. Totally love that. So cute. So cute. I'm so impressed right now. Okay, and the last thing is a pair of jeans. These are by Democracy. They're 12 Petite. Let's see what they are. They're just like a skinny leg. I don't really need these. I have a ton of jeans, but you gotta love a nice stretchy waistband for when you eat too many tacos or whatever. And the inseam does look just right. So I'll try these on, I guess, since I'm going to be trying on all the other stuff, I'll try this on so you can kind of see the inseam. But, yeah, I want to try this stuff on for you guys. I'm surprised. And these do have like this interesting seaming at the back right here. I'm wondering if it's supposed to like make your butt look really round. That would be good. All right. Well, I'm going to try this stuff on and see if I want to keep any of it. So this top is so cute. So it does like, I have this problem with every button-up shirt I own. So I usually take a safety pin and I'll like pin it right at this edge right here from the inside and then button up the next button. So that's what I would have to do. But yeah, this is the outfit that I was thinking of when I saw this. I would absolutely wear this like to the playground or to the flea market or something like that. So cute. I was really worried that it wouldn't fit my chest. But aside from the little puckering, it does seem to, it is obviously sheer. So I am wearing a like camisole underneath with like lace, which is what you can see here, but just super adorable little top. So for this skirt, it is really cute and it's perfectly swishy. Obviously it is a little bit tight because I mean I have on shapewear right now and this is like, I wouldn't pick this size. I would definitely need, I think, an extra large, but I do really like the cute print. And where did the, oh, it came undone. I really like this little fabric belt too, although I think you might have to like knot it because it just came undone. So it might be, yeah, it's a little like slippery, so I think you would need to like somehow knot it on itself or like maybe go back through. It's a little bit better. Okay, so because it's so tight, I didn't want to tuck the top in all the way, but I didn't want to hide the belt, so I did do a bit of a French tuck here. But yeah, really cute. I think I would totally wear this look. I do wish it had pockets, and I wish that the sizing had been a little bit more generous, but this is really cute. So this top, that drives me crazy, this top and these pants, it falls like exactly the line here. I have plenty of room, so I don't think I would need to wear shapewear, which I am because I'm about to try on this jumpsuit. So you can see I have on like a tank top underneath this. So I don't know that I would pair these two together. But I do think that the pants are at a nice length that is flattering. And they're, you know, stretchy and comfortable. They seem pretty true to size and they don't look like dumpy back here, which is nice. I can tell that they're like like form-fitting styles, so that's good. And yeah, I just don't need pants, but I do like these. And I could see these being like a really comfortable, like chase the kids kind of pant. Okay, I mean, this is pretty cute. I think it's a little tight here. It does not zip up the back, so I would definitely need an extra large. I can't, like my rib cage area is too big. I love that it has pockets, and they're actually pretty deep, so I feel like I could get my phone in there. I'm gonna test it. So here's my phone. Let's see. Like, you know, I mean, that's pretty good. And because it's like here, I feel like if it wasn't so tight, like it wouldn't be so obvious. But you know how when you put your phone in your pocket, sometimes it can like sag your clothes down and make them look kind of dumpy on one side. But this, because the pockets are higher, I don't think it does that. I do like the belt. Yeah, just it's too tight. So for a little bit of a change up, yeah, I decided to try the sweater that they sent on over the jumper. The jumpsuit. Pretty cute. I mean, this is like a nice stretchy material. The neckline is flattering. I love a good like bateau neckline here. And it's got definitely that like vintage kind of fit and feel to it, so I think it would pair really nicely with skirts. I just don't need another black sweater, but if this were in like a different color, then I could definitely see myself picking this up and owning it, because it's pretty comfortable and I like the three-quarter sleeve. The proportion is nice, and yeah, I think it's cute. So how did you guys feel about that try on? Because honestly, aside from the sizing being off on a couple of things, I'm like really impressed right now. And yeah, I like it. So let's find out how much all the different pieces were. I did see that they sent this thing about how to measure yourself, and then they sent a tape measure, like one of the movable, flexible tape measures. Which is great because I can always use these for my business. But yeah, that's really nice, really helpful for someone who's never taken their own measurements before. So they sent a very detailed, like, personal stylist message. And let's see, the sweater from MAC was $38. That is about on par with MAC sweaters. The floral belted maxi midi skirt was $48, and the all over galaxy jumpsuit was $58. The Reina sleeveless floral organza top, which is that like sheer daisy top that I loved so much, $32. Not bad. Really happy about that. And the jeans from Democracy were $72. And then I had a styling credit for $25 because that's what I paid to get my box. So yeah, I am not upset about that. So I will leave my referral down in the comments below. It's like here on the page, so I'll just put it down below. And if you are under 5'4" or even like 5'5" and you want to try this styling service, I like really am impressed by the amount of like quirky and fun things that fit into my actual closet. It felt almost like I was unboxing like something from ModCloth, so I was very happy with it. And I think that definitely got, because you know Stitch Fix is sort of moving into like a more automated sort of styling, like the stylists have less of a part of it, but I feel like from what she wrote down that at Short Story they're like actually manually putting together the box that they send you. So that being said, I recommend this styling service. I was not sure. I Don't know why I put off opening this box for so long. I guess I thought it was just going to be like another kind of boring Stitch Fix situation, but here I am. Really happy. So I will definitely be ordering another short story box. You can expect to see another unboxing here on my channel. And let me know down in the comments what your favorite piece was and if you plan on trying this styling service too. I like absolutely always forget to say this, but hit the like button. That would be very excellent. And don't forget to subscribe. So if you have not watched any of my other videos before, or you've seen them come up a couple of times and you've watched them but you haven't hit the subscribe button down below, please go ahead and hit that red button and turn it gray. And if you turn on notifications with the little bell, then you'll get notified every time that I put out a video. And YouTube is changing their algorithm, of course, so that's really one way to help guarantee that you get to see my videos. So that is that spiel. I really appreciate all of you who watch my styling content. I know a lot of people are here for me to talk about vintage and reselling and give you tips that way, but this is just something that I really love to do. I love clothing. That's why I'm in this business in the first place. So I appreciate those of you who tune in for my unboxing videos and styling videos. And I hope that I will see you for my next one. All right, you guys have a great day. Bye.